Hello everyone, today we are going to cover two points in this lecture. First one is a air vessel and second one is a indicator diagram for reciprocating pump. In last lecture we studied the construction and working of reciprocating pump and slip of the pump. You get the link in description box also. Now we will see the importance of air vessel and the use of air vessel in reciprocating pump. We know that the reciprocating pumps are pulsating type of pump. That means the rotary motion, it get converted into reciprocating motion by some arrangement, and therefore the piston moves in reciprocating direction. Here we can see that it moves back and forth direction, and at same time a negative pressure is generated inside the cylinder. Here you can see that when piston moves from top dead center toward bottom dead center, the suction valve get open and water sucked into the cylinder cavity. Further movement of crank, it result into the displacement of piston from bottom dead center towards top dead center, and it increases the pressure of water. When the pressure of water get increases, it will flow from delivery pipe. But the important point in reciprocating pump is that when negative pressure is generated inside a cylinder, that time suction valve get opened, but at same time we didn't get the discharge. It means it does not give a continuous discharge. To avoid this limitation, we use air vessel. Now you have to write some points which are important in exam point of view. You have to write construction and working of air vessel. We will discuss the first point, that is construction. Air vessel is a cast iron or a fabricated steel chamber which contains compressed air at the top portion and the water at the bottom portion of chamber. Here you can see that this is an air vessel in which the white portion is represented by compressed air. It has an opening at the base through which water can flow. Air vessel is fitted either on a suction pipe near to the suction valve or on a delivery pipe near to the delivery valve or on a both side. It is always near to the cylinder. Now we will see the working of air vessel in reciprocating pump. Here you can see that when the piston moves from top dead center towards bottom dead center, the suction valve get open and the water comes from some tank towards the cylinder cavity. And when the piston moves from bottom dead center towards top dead center, at same time the delivery valve get open and the water flow, high pressure water flow into the delivery pipe. During the middle of delivery stroke, when the pump is forced the water into the delivery pipe at a velocity greater than the average velocity, excess water flow into the air vessel and compress the trapped air in the upper portion of a chamber. You can see that when the excess water is a flow from delivery chamber, it will move in air vessel, and the amount of water is get increases. At the same time, the air present in air vessel get compressed. At the end of stroke, this water flows out of vessel to keep discharge more uniform. Now we see the indicator diagram for reciprocating pump. The graph between pressure head in the cylinder and stroke length of piston for one complete revolution of a crank is called as indicator diagram. When the piston moves from top dead center towards bottom dead center, the crank covers 0 degree towards 180 degree rotation, and the piston when moves from bottom dead center towards top dead center, the crank rotates from 180 degree to 0 degree, that is one complete revolution. And when it is going to happen, at that time the pressure is increases in the cylinder, which is plot on y-axis, that is pressure head, and the length of stroke is plot on x axis 0 degree and 180 degree. Now we see that how it is constructed. On x axis we use pressure head, and on x axis we plot 0 degree to 180 degree movement. When a crank move from 0 degree to 180 degree, we get suction stroke, and when it moves from 180 degree to 0 degree, we get delivery stroke. This is an atmospheric pressure line, and when we get suction stroke, we get a suction head. It is shown by vertical line. The indicator diagram, it is a ideal system one. Therefore, we use the horizontal lines are same, and when the crank is move from 180 degree towards 0 degree, that time we get discharge head, that is a delivery head also. And we construct the diagram in this way. Area of indicator diagram is proportional to the work done of pump. Now we see the application of reciprocating pump. First one is, reciprocating pump are used in industrial hydraulics and pneumatic system. It is used for oil drilling operation, water treatment and chemical plant. In this lecture we are going to study the remaining part of centrifugal pump. Students, it is not possible for me to send you updated video personally. To get information about upcoming video, please subscribe. Thank you.